Close your eyes, nice and softly. Just close the eyes gently so that the face is soft and not scrunched up or tight in any way. We'll take our three breaths. Take a breath in through the nose. And sigh out through the mouth. Another breath in. Another one in. Bring your hands together into prayer pose and open your eyes. Namaste. So you can drop your hands back down to your knees and lift your shoulders up to your ears. And as you breathe out, drop the shoulders. And again. And drop them. And lift them.
I was going to say,
make big circles.
When have we ever done mandalas?
Yeah, we should have actually done them today because there's no one online. Maybe I'll fetch them and we'll end with a little bit of mandalas.
Yeah.
Okay, we'll end. Yeah, because the people there sit and watch you because they don't have a mandala. Yeah. Well, one day I'll send one to everyone, and that's the one that must print on cover. Take your one arm up, bring your other hand down to the mat next to you, reach up through that arm, and slide your hand away and reach over the head. Feeling that stretch up the side of your body.
Oh, I can reach in from further.
Wow. And come all the way up again. Bring your hand down to the mat. Other arm up. Reach up through that arm. Slide your hand away and bend. See if you can keep sitting with both butt cheeks on the mat.
Look, I can.
Nice. Breathe in. Come all the way up. Take your hands behind you. Yes, well, feet are together. Bring your hands to your knees. Breathe in as you reach forward like a cow pose, but it's a sitting cow. Breathe out, bring your knees together. Chin to the chest, lean back. Cat. Inhale to seated cow.
Cat.
And breathe out as you round back. Come back up to sitting. And we're actually going to come to standing at the front of our mat. We're going to do two sun salutations.
I just crossed my legs like this, and then I just fell like this.
No, but just in case they log on, I'm not paying attention. All right, standing in mountain pose, feel your feet nice and strong. Soften your shoulders and breathe in. Sun, rain your fingers down. Tickle your toes as you hang down. Your hands to the mat and step or jump your feet back to plank. Bring your knees to the mat, chin and chest to the mat, and breathe in, cobra. Tuck your toes, push back to down dog.
Do you know what?
What?
I was gonna do at home. I was gonna do some down dog with my dog.
That would have been fun. Jump your feet forward. Tickle your toes as you hand down low. And breathe in, come all the way up. Push into the feet, get tall. Hello, sun.
Hello, sun.
And rain your fingers down. Tickle your toes as you hang down low. Hands to the mat. And step, perhaps jump your feet back as close as a plank. Knees to the mat. Chin and chest to the mat. Legs are together, cobra. and lower all the way down. Tuck your toes. Push back to down dog. And step or jump your feet forward. And tickle your toes as you hang down low. Come all the way up to standing. Bring your hands together into prayer pose. And exhale to pray. Beautiful, still. Release your hands. And come down to sitting. So today, I thought we were all sick and tired, not being allowed to go anywhere. So I thought we'd go on a journey. So let's pack our bags for Egypt. Let's open our bag nice and wide. Oh. And we're going to reach up high and grab our mat. And put it in.
So that's probably what I'm traveling.
And we'll come all the way up.
Because
reach to the left and grab. What do you want to take on your travels to
pizza. Binoculars.
Binoculars. And put them in the bag. Wonder what we're going to see in Egypt with our binoculars. Come all the way back up, reach to the other side.
Maybe we can go bird
watching.
Yeah. Nobody watching. Bird watching.
Yeah.
Like Stefan.
What are we going to grab on this side?
A hat.
A hat. And put it in the bag.
A jumping hat.
And come all the way
back. What if we go camping in Egypt?
You can get a tent. All the way up. Do you think we'll go camping?
Yeah, maybe we can go to
the tent in the bag. Push it down. And then come all the way back up. And turn to the other side and take pack some
marshmallows for the kids. Yeah. Yeah. And chairs.
Well, shouldn't we first pack clothes? And because we don't have room for them after we come.
Yeah.
Let's pack up all our clothes. Boom. Into the bag and then come all the way back up.
And now
some marshmallows. And with the marshmallows, we're going to take some toiletries. So we can clean our teeth after we've had the marshmallows. And fold them all into the bag. And I want you to zip your bag up.
And some kids. What about camping?
No, we're flying in an aeroplane. We can't. Zip your bag. It's good. All right. And let's drive to the airport.
Well, let's start from all the way down to here. Wait, first go in front, so you need to reverse from your pocket.
Yeah, there we go. Yeah, it's reverse, and now we're going on the road. We're going to go fast. So we're going to go. And we got to the airport just in time. Quickly come up standing.
Hop in the aeroplane.
And somebody has to be still. Put your seatbelts on, everybody. As we go into the aeroplane, it takes off. Keep your balance, focus. We're landing in Nigeria to refill. Zambia to refill. Take the other leg up to the back. Arms reaching behind you. Lifting the foot off the mat.
Look this. Left arm.
Keep your tummy nice and tight.
Left arm.
Oh, on your mat, on your mat. Stay on your mat. Stay on your mat. And land. Very nice. Balance the whole time. And when we got to Egypt, the sky was blue. And we saw the sun. So we reached up high into the sky, pushing into the feet and grabbed some sun. Ha!
Ha!
And the other side, ha, side.
Ha!
All the way up again. Ha!
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 And all the way up.
But isn't the sun made out of fire?
Ha!
Ha! Ha!
We just grabbed the sunshine.
Ha!
And we were so happy that we're going to breathe in. And we're going to go like this first. We're going to go. Did you? Okay, good. I'm glad. All right.
I did this at home.
So then we decided we were going to take a boat down the River Nile. So the Nile River is the Nile River is the long river that runs from the top of Africa all the way through the whole of Egypt and past Egypt. And that's a beautiful big river. And we took a boat onto the river. Row, row, row your boat gently down the stream. Merrily, merrily. You can put your toes up. Life has got up. Row, row, row your boat gently down the Nile. Merrily, 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 merrily. Oh, the crocodile. Let's do the other side. And roll back down the arms.
There are crocodiles in the river, so why not?
Have your knees into the chest.
And rock and roll.
Coming up into all fours. Hands under shoulders, knees under hips. In Egypt, they think cats are very precious and holy. So they really, really, really respect cats. So we did a seated cat cow. Now we're doing another one because they're so special. So drop your tummy and reach forward with the chest. Let's make this happy cat. And round the shoulders, chin to chest. And cat.
No, like this.
Inhale, drop your tummy and reach forward with the chest.
You know what? I love my kitten.
Sit nicely like this. Be
my
nice and
kitten's not even one of
us. Be nice and still like this. Let's do two cats. Round the shoulders, chin to chest. Go. Laurel, stay nicely. Push into the hands. Really round the shoulders. One more time. Drop the tummy. Reach forward to the chest.
Yeah.
And round. Angry cat. Push into the mat. Tuck your toes and push back.
Down
pyramid pose, guys.
Pyramid.
Yes, but down dog looks like a pyramid. Do you know the pyramids in Egypt?
Potato.
Who said they don't know the pyramids?
Me.
Okay. I'll show you a pyramid. Come on, have a look at
a pyramid. I know a pyramid. A pyramid. It's just like this pile of sand pointing up.
It's not a pile of sand. It's big rocks.
I thought it was just a pile of sand.
No.
It's yellow. I've seen a pyramid before. I've seen a pyramid. My mom's phone covers.
Those are some pyramids. So that bit at the top is this underneath where it's a different color, means that the stone's worn away. But they're huge rocks. They're huge. Just take a cut out the rest, really. Let's see if I can find a better one. And look how big they are. That's looking from the air.
You know, we were climbing there. We were climbing.
See, that's a picture from the air. You couldn't even see a car down there. Wow. They're very big. And inside the pyramids, they've got tunnels and rooms.
But then how do you get in there?
Well, you're not allowed in there anymore because people have been in, but now you can't just get people in there because they don't respect it. And then ancient stuff there. And they don't know how they carry the rocks there to make those pyramids, because the rocks of the pyramid weigh like the like 20 cars or something. And they had no machinery that we knew of back then. So how did they lift those rocks and position them perfectly when they were already a few rocks high? How did they get them so high?
Well, maybe they chop down like a heavy tree and like put everything on the tree. Hmm. Maybe they like took something like a big piece of wood or something and lifted it. Like took a whole group of people and lifted it up.
And it took them many years to build. So pyramids are very interesting and very special. So let's go back to our pyramid poems. Down dog today. And imagining that this inside space here is our hollow chamber. They call it chambers inside the pyramids. Reach your butt up high in the air, sticking your head in the air like you just don't care. Take your right leg up behind you and step your foot through between the hands. Bring your foot down, your other foot down to the mat so we can do warrior one. Because they always said that inside the pyramids were the pharaohs, the kings of Egypt buried. But I'll tell you a secret about that now too. So this is our strong pharaoh king pose. Look at my tall crown on my head. And bring your hands down to the mat and step your foot back
to
down.
Look at my pokey crown.
And breathe in, take your other leg up. And step that foot through between your hands. So we can do warrior one on the other side, and I can tell you that secret about the pyramids. Arms up, warrior one. So they always said that the pharaohs were buried in the pyramids, but they've never found one buried in the pyramids. So we think the pyramids were used for something else. And bring your hands down to the mat. And come to sitting with the soles of the feet together. They also said that the treasures of the pharaohs were buried in the tombs. One automatically wants to do this. So walk forward with the hands, and then inside this treasure chest, you're going to open the treasure chest up, looking up, open your chest.
Well, my chest just has water in it.
Water is a treasure in itself. Close your treasure chest. And then open the treasure chest. It's a difficult
like
word
the
to
pirates.
Say. Treasure chest. It's a bit of a tongue twister. Hey.
Treasure chest. Treasure.
Bring your. We do have a treasure in our chest. This is my own personal treasure chest. Oh my word. Your clip's coming out, Laurel. Your clip is coming out now. All right.
Have you ever noticed I have a friend?
It's got to be long. Let us bring our hands down. Lift your knees up.
I want to slide that point forward.
And see if you can come onto your toes like this. And from there, see if you can come all the way up to standing on your toes. On your toes. On your toes. See if you can come all the way.
Did you ever notice I had a leaf tooth?
You told me last week. Okay. Good. Stay on the toes. And you still got one. They always say that you walk like an Egyptian, and they always do this funny thing. So we're going to do that too. Lift one knee and the opposite arm. But do it properly as a yoga pose. I want you to stand hand balance. On the hips level. And then I want you to change arms and legs. Nice and slowly. And change. And change, Laurel. Nice and strong and tall, not though. Nice and strong and tall. Come, let me see you do it properly. Do it. Stand in the middle of the front. Knee up, opposite arm up. Keep that balance. No, not me. Keep your balance. Knee up. Tighten the tummy.
It's like a seagull picking kind of thing.
Do the other side.
It's like us picking something.
Tighten your tummy. Tighten your leg.
It's like a sprout.
It is, yeah.
We are picking.
And change sides.
We're picking, picking.
And change sides.
We need to do fast and fast.
Oh, that would be far too fast. Come to chair pose as you pull the hips back, making a throne for your underarm, a throne for your pharaoh and his queen. Make your tummy tight, a head between the arms. I want to see you work. Bend your knees a little bit more. And all the way up along the beautiful Nile River of palm trees. Find your focus. I want stillness. I want your focus. Bring your weight onto your right foot. Bring your left foot for tree pose. Remembering wherever you need your balance is where you have your foot. When you're ready, breathe in and take your arms up. I want to see you strong and focused. Growing in length, breathing. Seeing if you can balance for a long time, just focusing, being strong, tummy tight, knee pulling back, reaching up. Very nice. Change sides. Bring your hands back to prayer pose. Keep the stillness. Keep the stillness. Release your hands. Release your foot. And bring your weight onto the other foot as you come into tree pose on the other side. Finding something to look at. Call that your drishti or your focal point. Make the leg you're standing on nice and tight. Tighten the muscles. Pull that bent knee back. Hands to prayer. When you're ready, breathing in, taking the arms up. Let's see if you can balance nice. Yeah, yeah. Beautiful, Laurel Lighten. You can also do it well. Good, beautiful. And bring your palms together, exhale
kind of like,
to prayer.
The palms are kind of like namaste.
Release your hands down and your foot down. Take your arms wide out to the sides. Lengthen through your fingers. Bring your arms all the way up. Working into the feet and folding forward. Bring your hands to the mat and step one of your legs back. Drop your knees to the mat. Straighten out the foot. And breathe in to crescent moon pose. Because it's a beautiful night. The desert, Egypt is a desert. It's clear and we are exploring the pyramids at night. Make your hips sink lower, bend back. And bring your hands down to the mat. Tuck the toe, lift the knee, and step your foot forward. And then change sides. Step your other foot back. Drop your knee to the mat. And breathe in. Take your arms up. Make your hips sink a little bit closer down to the mat. Reach up to your arms and bend back. And release your hands down to the mat. Tuck your toes, lift your knee, and turn side on the mat. Pulling your head down towards the mat.
I can do it.
Okay, well, sweetie, you can. You can sit in that.
Because he's so little.
Yeah. And now we're going to take our arms up, wide out to the sides, coming to a beautiful big star in the night sky. Shining. And you can bring that. Come to sitting.